the presidents of the this conference, comrade Madam Hamalada, the general secretary of this CITU, my dear colleague and comrade Tapan Sen, and Mr. Samandarajan and Sukumaran and the rest of the office bearers, and all the our colleagues, trade union leaders of this very important recognition in the whole India, and all the participants of this all over the country of the CITU, I thanks to everyone. And first of all, I thanks to the leaders of the CITU to give me an opportunity to address in this August House. On behalf of Labour Progressive Federation, as well as the Dravida Munnetra Kazhagam leader, our M.K. Stalin, we are greet this conference and the success of all our deliberations, and we will with you now. And I thanks to Amarjit Kaur because she has elaborately everything she has spoken, and it took a much of time because we have to know, we need not to go in detail. But one thing, for the present government, what they are doing, what is the role of the government, that everyone should understand. Once Tapan Sen told that we have to go into the deep of the grassroots level of the our unions and the workers, we have to bring all the workers from their home to seat. That is a very important role. Now it is necessary. Until and unless we will do, we can't survive. Within these 4 years, they will do everything. Don't worry. But they can do in the parliament only, not in the floor of the India, in the before the working class. Everyone, they don't know about the economy. Even the finance minister also. She is worried about the corporates only. After this economic slowdown, the South India affected so much. Most of the automobile sector, the automobile hubs have been laid off. The very prestigious company, the TVS, who is manufacturing the major accessories of the ancillary accessories of the this country, all the for all the automobile sector, that have been laid off for weekly 4 days. But they don't worry about it. You see, they are not ready to give any concession to the farmers. Farmers, whatever they are producing, within some days they have to sell it, otherwise it will be spoiled. But the automobile sector, they are producing car. It can be sold 1 or 2 years afterwards also. But they are worried much about the corporates. They are giving the tax benefit and everything. But lakhs of workers have been laid off. They are all in the field. They are all in the jobless. But the government has not worried about them, and they are not giving answering to them also. When we are asking the ministers, why you are closing down all the even profit-making public sector also? Simply they are giving answer. The government have no business to run the business. Then what for the government is coming? Only for looting and taking away the wealth of this India. That is their own agenda that they are doing. In all the sectors, even the agriculture sector, if they want to develop the economy, they have to develop the rural area. We are asking them, the migration is too much from the agrarian parts to the urban area. But the government have no idea to how to give the developments and how to give the skill for the rural areas. The rural area only improve the GDP of the country, but they doesn't care about it. They are caring about the only the corporate company only. They are giving some benefits to the corporates. They are looting the banks also. In government sector, there is no recruitment, ban on recruitment. That is the mistake of the government. For what purpose the ban on recruitment is implemented? The government sector to serve for the nation and the public. That means the government doesn't want to serve the government to the public. If the ban on, because of the ban on recruitment, the posts are vacant after 2 years and the vacant posts have been vanished. There is no employability, but they are saying we are creating employment. By all the sector, their own act, they are doing such a confusion activities. Neither they improving the economy, nor they developing the country, but they are amending so much of bills because they have the brutal majority. Once in 1962, our beloved leader, great leader Anna, spoke in the Rajya Sabha. At the time Congress was ruling, he was asking the government, you may be in number more, but we may be the number in less, but you must listen. You can pass anything, but first you listen as our, what we are, for what we are representing, and we can also say something for the development of the India. At the time, the same, we are also asking to the government of India, listen to the people, the opposition, and then you can do whatever you like. But they are not, they are murdering the democracy. How they are bringing the bill? They are not following any procedure. But they are interpreting in so many ways. They are forcing the media persons and the press persons also not to publish their original everything. These are all happening in all over India. Now what we have to do, all the central trade union, irrespective of any political variation, for a long back, it is a unique unity in India. We have joined together and we fight for this working class, and we are going ahead. Last 8th January strike, it is a prestigious strike. Every workers, even the unorganized labor, they have come out from the house and they have stand on the roads. It is a very good strike. It is a challenge for the government, so that we are 97% of voting strength. Working class. We have to join together, we have to united, we have to mobilize the working class first. We have to ask the political parties. I'm also one of the political party. We have to ask, pressurize the political party to achieve and to give the benefit for this working class, then only we will vote for you. Such a pressure should come from our working class that we want. In our Tamil Nadu, for many years onwards, we joined together. We fight for many things. Even our government has come. We are all joined together. We represent to the government and we are achieving so many things. You never thought. In 2001, there was a very great strike, 17-day strike. Many number of workers are also in the jail. Many number of workers have been dismissed. But after successive government has come, that government has ratified, the strike was taken as a legal, and we have given all the benefit. It was a unique achievement. These are all we have done it. So that I request all over the part of the country. So we have to join together. We have to fight for it. The government will not do it. You see in the Nokia company in Sriperumbudur, they have closed down. Why they have closed? The Nokia has not paid the tax of 24,000 crores for the central and 2,004 crores for the state. But we don't know. We are pressurizing. CPIM and DMK pressurizing the government whether you collect the money or not. The government is not giving any answer. Even the time of the Arun Jaitley, now is the time of the Nirmala Sitharaman, they are not giving any response. But then, if you have not collect that money, why you are allowing that Nokia to run the business in India? How you are doing? Such a things, many public sector undertaking, they are going to be closed because when we ask in the house, what is your program for this disinvestment and everything? They are giving entire list of the public sector. Entire list of the... We are going to sell it everything. How to make up your budget? We will sell the government property and then we will make up the budget. For this, to sell everything, in Tamil, we used to say, Kundi tindral kundrum malum. If you sit and eat, even if it is in a mountain of wealth also be vanished. Such a things is happening in this government, so that it is a crucial time for the working class. We have to unite it once again. So in this CITU conference, on behalf of Labour Progressive Federation, once again, I greet all the success of this conference and all the deliberations, thanking you, all of you. Thank you.